Hello, I'm François from Shakmat, and in this video I will show you our new module, the Bard Quartet. The Bard Quartet is a 4-channel quantizer. It allows to edit independently on the 4 channels different scales. The module has a lot of advanced features such as microtuning, arpeggiator options, 3 different assignable output and input, and also the harmony potentiometer, which allows to easily recall different sets of scales and options. In a few words, making harmonic evolutions inside a modular composition is not a big deal anymore with a Bard Quartet. In order to edit a scale, simply use the keyboard button over here. To select or unselect a note, simply press the corresponding button on the keyboard. The active note is brighter than the other selected ones. Let's now create a sequence coming from the Harlequin's context. Let's now choose the second channel using the channel buttons. Let's choose channel 2, for example, and let's run another sequence. So, different scales on different channels. We can also group the channels together. Let's press the buttons of the channels to be grouped together. So 2 buttons will be on at the same time to show the channels are grouped. As you see, channels 3 and 4 are alone, but it's possible to create 2 different groups. Now we have 2 groups, 1, 2 and 3, 4. It is also possible to create a group of 3 or of 4 different channels. 2, 3 and 4 are grouped, and 1 is just alone. So now, if you edit a scale on a certain channel, it will also affect the scale on the other channel from the same group. There are more options about grouping. It will be rediscussed a bit later when we will see the different menus. A very important feature of the Bard Quartet is the harmony. The harmony allows to create different scales and to recall them on the fly on different harmonies. Right now the potentiometer is pointing the first harmony. So let's take back our sequences coming from the Harlequin's context with different quantization on the 2 channels. If we switch to the second harmony, it looks like empty, like a C note on both channels. Let's create like a F minor scale, for example. We now have 2 different harmonies, and we can switch now to the first one. With this principle, we can very easily create harmonic evolutions of entire songs. And of course, the harmony can be modulated by CV using the harmony CV input. Let's now have a look to the edit menu, which can be accessed by pressing the edit button. This menu has 2 different sections, the octave switching part and the input-output assignations. Let's again take a sequence from the Harlequin's context. Per harmony, you can switch the octave of all the 4 channels independently. So let's switch the first channel. And as you can hear, you can switch from -3 to +3 octave. As octave transpose is per channel, you can switch to the second one and have independent octave switching for the first and second channel. Second part is the input-output assignations. So the first assignation is the trigger output. When activated, trigger output will cause the channel to deliver a trigger each time a note change is detected. As you can see, I have a trigger at the trigger output each time the note changes. Second assignation is a gate input, which will work as a track and hold. So let's use the second channel of the time wizard for this application. It delivers short 4 millisecond triggers. Or we can use another channel, which delivers gates. The channel of the Bard Quartet with the gate input activated will only track its input when the gate signal is high. The third and last assignation is the transpose input, which can work in 4 different ways. It can be off as it is now, it can be per octave, pre-quantizer or post-quantizer. Octave works as a voltage control octave switcher. So let's take the third channel of the Harlequin's context, which is an offset, and let's send it to the transpose input. Let's now set the assignation input as octave for this channel. Let's now choose the pre-quantizer option, meaning the transpose input will be summed to the input of the channel before quantization. Third type of the transpose input assignation is the post-quantizer. The transpose input will be quantized in semitones and then added to the output of the channel, so you can shift chromatically your scale. To exit the edit menu, just press the edit button. Let's now have a look to the microtuning capabilities of the Bard Quartet. On the two first channels, we have very simple scales, which are C and G. To enter the microtuning menu, just press the microtuning button. Then select the note you want to edit with the microtuning. Let's hear what's happening. We have two different VCOs in tune. Let's now press the note you want to edit, the C note, and the microtuning works that way. Once the note is selected, use a potentiometer. At noon, the note will be completely in tune. While going clockwise, you will increase the microtuning of maximum 50 cents. Going counterclockwise, you can microtune your note until minus 50 cents. Play with microtuning now with the sequence. We will only microtune the first channel. Let's work on the G note. Let's tune it a bit higher or with a lower tuning. As you can see, the microtune notes are blinking. If at a certain time you just want to erase everything, press the microtuning for 4 seconds and you will erase the microtuning for each note. To exit the microtuning menu, just repress the button Mutune. Let's now have a look at the arpeggiator features of the Bard Quartet. To access the arpeggiator menu, just press the ARP button. In this menu, you can decide to activate the arpeggiator function for each channel. If you want to activate, for example, the arpeggiator for the channel 1, just press in this menu the corresponding channel with the ARP button. Let's do it for the two first channels. You can see those channels are no arpeggiator because the channel button is no blinking. The channel inputs expect no triggers instead of CVs. Let's take two outputs of the time wizard to feed the Bard Quartet inputs. Let's go back to the scale mode and let's see what's happening. Back to the arpeggiator menu, you can act on the octave spread and arpeggiator mode. For the octave spread, you can go from 1 octave to 2, 3 or 4 octaves. Let's go back to 2 octaves. And we have now the different modes. Up, down, pendulum, spiral, and random. Let's go back to down on 2 octaves and let's choose for the second channel pendulum. Okay, we can go now to the second harmony. We edited a scale which is up from 1 tone. And we can edit different arpeggiator parameters for this harmony. When a channel is set as an arpeggiator, there is a third option for the gating assignation in the edit menu. Activate gating as a track and hold, and there is a third option which makes the button blinks, which is a reset for the arpeggiator. Let's send channel number 6 from the time wizard to the gating of the Bard Quartet. To exit this menu, simply press the up button. Let's now have a look to the memory menu of the Bard Quartet. To enter this menu, press the edit button along the up button. The edit button is now on as the up button is now blinking. In this menu, you can do two things. First, you can save and load your harmonies in 10 different slots of 8 harmonies, which are in a non-volatile memory, meaning you can keep your scales when powering down your modular system. Secondly, you can copy a certain harmony on a certain channel to another harmony slash channel in the current slot. So let's show an example of the intra slot manipulation. So for example, let's copy the first channel, first harmony, and let's say we want to copy on the fourth channel, fourth harmony. Let's go back to the memory menu. We are on channel 1, harmony 1. Hold the R button and choose the destination. Channel 4, harmony 4, and release the R button. Channel button just gave you a feedback by blinking. And so now we have the same scale here and over here. Like we said earlier, the memory menu also allows to access the non-volatile memory, meaning you can store your scale, everything in the edit menu, the arpeggiator settings, and the microtuning into the non-volatile memory. Let's first load a certain slot. There are 10 different slots with factory presets. Among those presets, you can find on the first slot a blank slot, only with C, no microtuning, no arpeggiator, no options. There are 6 different slots with harmonic evolutions, for example, based on different degrees of a C minor. And there are 3 different slots where you can find very useful scales, and one of the slots also contains scales involving microtuning. If you want, for example, to load this slot, press the button corresponding to this slot and then press the C sharp, which is a loud button, and there we go. For each harmony, you have now different scales loaded on the different channels. Let's now reload the first slot, the factory blank slot. Now, in order to save the current slot, press the button corresponding to the destination slot. Press the D-sharp button, which is a save button. It is now stored into the non-volatile memory. Let's now have a look to the option menu. You access the option menu by pressing the edit button and the mute-tune button at the same time. Edit button is on, as the mute-tune button is blinking. In this menu, you can find two different things, the channel grouping options and the channel interactions. The channel grouping option means what will happen when you group channels together. You have three different options. No button on means only the scales are grouped. If you press on C-sharp, scales and edit menu will be grouped. And if you press on the D-sharp button, scales, edit menu, arpeggiator menu and mute-tune menu will be grouped also. Let's now have a look to the channel interaction options. This defines the way a certain channel behaves when a 0 volt is detected at its input. So it is a per channel option. And there are three different options. First one is no interaction, meaning the channel is completely independent from what is happening on the previous channel. The second option is a software normalization, meaning when the module detects a 0 volt at a certain input, the corresponding channel will follow the previous channel input. Third option is the analog shift register. In order to make the analog shift register work, you have also to go to the edit menu and to activate the gate input for the channel you want to be involved in the analog shift register. Let's go back to the options menu and configure the channels as analog shift register by choosing the last option, analog shift register, so the A sharp button. Each time a trigger will be sent in the trigger input, it will cause the channels configured as analog shift register to follow the output voltage that was generated before the trigger is received. So for example, if each channel is involved in this system, each time a trigger will be received in the trigger input, channel 1 will give its voltage to channel 2, channel 2 will give its voltage to channel 3, and channel 3 will give its voltage to channel 4, meaning you can create with only one sequence, four different shifted sequences. Last but not least, let's have a look to different features quite useful for performance and for editing the module. The first one is editing all harmonies at a time. This feature is only available in the Edit, Mute-tune and Arpeggiator menu. This feature allows to do a certain action on all the harmonies. To do so, press on the corresponding channel, press on the action you want to do. For example, we want to shift two octaves up the third channel and so for all the harmonies. Second advanced feature is the harmony potentiometer freeze. This allows to jump from one harmony to another with a potentiometer without passing by the in-between harmonies. So for example, if I want to jump from harmony number 1 to harmony number 8 without passing by the in-between harmonies, I just hold the mute-tune button while turning the potentiometer. So as you can see, we have buttons still blinking. It's because I'm still holding freeze, and when I'm releasing it, no, I'm in the eighth harmony. Last feature is the output voltage norm. Normally, this module works in Eurorack environment with a standard volt per octave behavior, but you can configure for each channel to make the output works with hertz per volt, so Korg and Yamaha standard. Also a Buchla standard, meaning 1.2 volt per octave. To edit the output norm, you have to go to the mute-tune menu, then hold the mute-tune button while clicking on the channel you want to edit the output norm. So by pressing one time, the button is blinking, meaning we have the core gamma standard. Let's repress one time. The button is now double blinking, meaning we have the Buchla standard 1.2 volt per octave. Again, this feature is a per channel feature, meaning you can have the first channel working with your rack, the channel 2 and 3 with Buchla, and channel 4 with the MS-20, for example. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to check out our YouTube channel for more tutorials and patch IDs. Bye bye!